You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Linda, your host, and I have a friend of mine, Linda Siegel, from Family and Community Resources. I always get tempted to put that Brockton word in there, but you're more than Brockton.
Yes, we are more than Brockton.
And you are having another great event here in the City of Champions, and 24th of October, correct?
Yes, October 24th.
Tell us about it.
It is, we're calling the event, What Happens When Domestic Violence Comes to Work. What employers, managers, supervisors, and their employees need to know. It's on October 24th from 1 to 2:30 at the Holiday Inn Express at Westgate Mall. Mm-hmm. They've generously donated the space for us, which we're so happy for. But it's Domestic Violence Awareness Week.
Right.
And, you know, while the Supreme Court nomination process and ongoing revelations around the Me Too movement have brought domestic violence to the forefront, we still have a long way to go to change that narrative.
For sure.
21% of people report they've been victims of domestic violence. 64% of those who reported said that it impacts their work significantly. And 33% of women killed in the workplace are killed by an intimate partner. So with 1 in 3 women and 1 in 4 men saying that they've been victims of intimate partner abuse, someone in your office or where you work or
Absolutely.
Someone you know has been a victim. So we're bringing a panel together. Kim Kerrigan is moderating our event. This is a cause near and dear to her heart.
Mm-hmm.
So we're bringing a panel together. Kelly Dwyer, the executive director of the Governor's Council on Sexual Assault and Domestic Violence, will be there.
Okay.
Jennifer Duke, who is an employment attorney with Littler Mendelson, mm-hmm. will be there. Tom Carney, who is VP of Human Resources for Eastern Bank Group.
Okay.
And Laverne Gordon, who we know.
Absolutely.
Is also going to be there. So we will have a panel discussion. It should be a lively discussion about different aspects. You know, Laverne will speak from her perspective as a survivor and what that did to, you know, prompt her to found Love Life Now. Mm-hmm. Kelly will talk about the legal perspective. Tom, Human Resources, Jennifer, also talk about what employers and employees can do to help guide them through some of the challenges and come up with some strategies of what you can do to implement a safe workplace.
And I've gone to a lot of seminars, HR seminars, but I've never gone to one like this. I think more is needed, so we'll be there.
Excellent.
And we'll cover it. Okay, if that is in the cards, but it's better to go. You can watch anything you want on TV, but you don't get the same experience. And you
right.
know what? This doesn't just affect the person at work that is could be harmed.
No.
There are other people that could be in the crossfire, that could be hurt, that could be killed.
Correct.
Okay. I have a locked door. I had an incident once here when I let someone in the building.
Yeah.
Not specifically this particular topic, but you know, we're in downtown Brockton, we have Mainspring House and Father Bill's here, there are people all over, and you look at the door, a person looks okay, we're gonna let them in the door, well maybe they're not, maybe
right.
they have a substance abuse issue or something along those lines, and your agency specifically deals with all of this in a wonderful way to shed light on it, to educate people.
Yes.
Not to accuse people, to
Correct.
Educate people, and to prevention than anything else.
Right.
Right. And people are afraid. I know people. I've dealt with students. I teach at Massasoit. I have students. Someone could come into a school situation. We're not locked down. We don't have all the doors
right.
locked. Okay. We have campus police, but there are only so many of them, and it's a pretty spread out, pretty big campus.
Right. But in that situation, you know, it's, did the person tell someone, you know, I have this ex partner who has been abusive to me and this could be, you know, they might come here. I just need some help. And it's also it's being in a work environment that you feel comfortable enough to share that.
Mm-hmm.
And that's also one of the biggest problems is people don't tell.
Right.
For many reasons.
And sometimes people are afraid to get involved because they think there's repercussions, or that
right.
person isn't going to be their friend
right.
anymore, or whatever. You know, they keep saying, if you see something, say something. But this is more silent. Sometimes people go for years,
for a decade, years.
For two
and they're
decades.
Afraid to say anything.
And now you also add the mix in where you have people that have come to this country. Laverne talks about this all the time. They've come from Cape Verde or Haiti or something like that. They're in the process of becoming a legal citizen. They may not be a legal citizen yet. You say anything, you're getting deported.
Right.
So you're out the door. So they're in fear not only of their life, but their safety and security in this country.
Yes.
If kids were born and kids were involved, it just touches, and it touches the parents, the kids,
it
the relatives,
everyone.
The friends,
it's
everybody.
The whole community,
right.
from home to work. To you know, where you socialize after work, it does. It involves the entire community, and your every step you take during the day.
And the police can't be everywhere. We
and
have
the
people
can't be
that,
everywhere.
That specialize in this. We have a good police department here in Brockton. We have officers that are sensitive to all of these issues, but we don't have enough of them.
Right.
We don't have enough police in Brockton. We could have double the police in
right.
Brockton. We probably wouldn't have enough. And I've been told, I took part 1 year in the Citizens Police Academy, so I could see what they did and what they went through. The most dangerous call to go on is a domestic violence call. And there are way, way too many of them. So if people want to find out more information, your website?
Yes, you can go to fcr-ma.org. If you want to register, you can give me a call at 508-583-6498. I'm at extension 139. And you can also go online to panel.event@fcr-ma.org. We set up an email address just for the event.
Okay.
It promises to be a really lively and informative discussion. I'm excited to hear what our panelists have to say and the information that they can share. You know, a lot of human resources professionals don't know,
mm-hmm.
You know, what they can do. They're all so not entirely familiar with the laws in Massachusetts.
Right.
Which Kelly will touch on and Jennifer will as well. So it should be really exciting. And then just hearing Laverne tell her story, it just, you know.
Yeah, Laverne invited me to an event that she did at
Get you going.
Bryant Institute in Boston at Northeastern. It was kind of a celebration for all the people that helped her, and all sorts of other resources are there. It was a great discussion. We know she's a champion, but so are you, and so is Pat Kelleher and all the people that are at your agency. So I appreciate you coming on.
Thank you.
We're going to help you promote it. I know a few HR people. I'm going to tell them about it, okay, and give
Definitely.
Them the information.
Definitely.
And hopefully we'll have a nice big crowd. I haven't been there in a while.
I know. Well, it's the response has been great so far, so we're really excited. We think it's going to be a great afternoon.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
Okay. You're watching Greater Brockton. Mark Lindy, your host. Stay tuned for more events, places, people, and faces right here in the City of Champions.